As long as he needs me, I know where I must be, because he set me free. I'll feed him tenderly.
There's a mouse living in our composting outhouse. His name is George. He changed my life. I remember the first time I lifted the toilet seat and saw him down there in the sawdust. I thought he'd fallen in and couldn't climb out. So I put a piece of wood down like a ramp and left the seat up so he could escape. But the next day, he was still there. He was shivering, trying to warm himself in the gentle heat of the composting outhouse droppings. So I gave him a toilet paper square to use as a blanket. The next day, I discovered he'd used the square as a canvas for a painting. A painting of me. A painting painted with outhouse droppings. Every day, he left me another one. Sometimes more portraits of me. Sometimes inspirational words. Sometimes nature studies of the view from his home in the composting outhouse. He taught me to pay attention to the beauty all around. But lately, George has been down. He's stopped painting. I sense he needs new challenges. Needs to get out of the safety of the composting toilet and expand his view of the world. But he is afraid, doubting himself. I wanted to help him the way he helped me. I thought some peanut butter crackers and a cheery flower on my hat might inspire him to go forth and create again.
If you've been fear-bound, then you will know when someone sees you, it frees your soul. I know that I now must encourage him to trust himself and free him just the way that he freed me.
Hello, George. Are you awake, George?
What's to get up for when you have no talent?
Peanut butter crackers.
I don't deserve them.
Oh, that's not true, George. You've given me so much.
What have I given you?
What? Art. You taught me about concentration. I thought that meant just being still, but you taught me it meant much more. You taught me to be where I am, not some place in the past or future worrying about tomorrow. You taught me to believe in myself, to go forward. What about you, George? Are you working on something new?
No. I'm not working on anything new.
That is not like you, George.
I have nothing to say.
You have many things.
Well, nothing that's not been said.
Said by you,
though,
George.
I do not know where to go.
And nor did I.
I want to make things that count.
Things that will be new.
I did what I had to do.
What am I to do?
Move on. Stop worrying where you're going. Move on. If you can know where you're going, you've gone. Just keep moving on. I chose and my world was shaken. So what? The choice may have been mistaken. The choosing was not. You have to move on.
Look at what you want, not at where you are, not at what you'll be. Look at all the things you've done for me.
Opened up my eyes. Taught me how to see. Notice every tree.
Notice every tree.
Understand the light.
Understand the light.
Concentrate
on
now.
I want to move on.
I want to explore the light. I want to know how to get through. Through to something new. Something on my own. Move on. Move on.
Stop worrying if your vision is new. Let others make that decision. They usually do. You keep moving on. Look at what you've done.
Something in the light, something in the sky, in the grass, up behind the trees.
Look at all the things you gave to me.
Things I hadn't looked at till now. Flower on your hat, and your smile, and the color of your hair. And the way you catch the light. And the care. And the feeling. And the life. Moving on.
On.
Together.
We will always belong.
Just keep moving on.
Anything you do, let it come from you. Then it will be new. Give us more to see. White, a blank page or canvas. My favorite. So many possibilities. The next day, I had a feeling he'd be gone. But I knocked anyway, for old time's sake. And I found he'd left one last painting.